Yes, buddies, we need another chair for bedfire.
Yes.
Hop in, babe, we're going.
Woohoo!
Well, your new friends from the Netherlands used to have a house left into the mud, but an old RV called Penelope, she's a 1983. Pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves Rob until the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe.
Another shot of the merch.
Merch.
So where can we buy this merch?
Arvelicious.com/shop.
Yes. Good day, buddies. Battery charging day. We're charging the Goal Zero. We got Herman's battery, which we're charging as well with a smart charger. See, it's blinking. This is the progress. When it stops blinking, it's full. So what are we gonna do?
We're gonna clean out the storage space above the dashboard.
Yes, we have a dashboard with loudspeakers, but we cut all the cabling, so it doesn't work anymore anyway. Mm-hmm. And there's a bunch of stuff in here. Another one, but only my concern is that the loudspeakers support there are wedges in there. My concern is they support this. If we take them out, everything might crash. You never know, its previous owner put them there for a reason, to support everything.
Or just to listen to music. Empty it?
Empty the space.
Yeah.
So, a lot of clutter. The loudspeakers, everything is out.
Mm.
There's a bunch of cablings behind there.
Yep.
This side is another loudspeaker. Here's Peter representing the mice.
Yeah, I'm gonna take out the boxes if possible at all. Oh. Amazing! One. And then they should be loose. Yeah. Success. Now the second box. Wow. We did it.
Yeah.
It's empty. We got extra storage.
So, Peter's taping off the power cables.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And we were just discussing this roof hatch you cannot watch out. And we've seen in other campers they have like plastiglass or whatever it's called. So we were thinking if we just cut out a much bigger hole in the roof and put in one of these plastic roof hatches, then we can look at the stars and we can look up and see the UFOs and everything, which we now cannot see. And we get to see those things, so we can grab the vlogging cameras, vlog about it. See these bunch of cablings, buddies. Bunch of cablings with all kind of pieces and connectors, and just to get these lights on. This light, see, turned on and off. So. I'm for cutting it, what do you say?
You usually make the executive decisions.
So the executive decision has been made. We cut it. We cut it all again. Look. I don't know if you can see this. Look how much cabling this is for these old lights. Mm-hmm. What did you discover?
The lights still work. So yeah.
It's Benny.
And this one does not. Oh, it does. I just touched it.
And yeah, it does. They all work still.
Wow.
So all three lights still work. So yes. Meaning that all the cabling we cut out did not affect the lights.
It doesn't seem like it.
So. But we also don't know where, what supplies the power to the lights. We cut everything away. We cut everything away. So what is providing power to the lights? So under here, we cut all the wires by these. So what is up with it? On one side, it's handy that the lights still work.
Very handy.
So we can leave it at that for the moment.
Yeah.
Or we have to screw open the thing.
No, really.
And see if there's a wire.
But
yes.
But.
So the executive decision is being made
again.
To just remove the module, even though it looks like a spaceship. And we have another module here. It has an altimeter and it has like a stabilizing system.
Yes.
A stabilizing system for the van. We might just be able to remove that too, although it does look quite nice. So, by this, as you see, so from here, there's a wire coming, going to the light. This is where the power is coming from. I think if we cut that wire, and we're there. Look, buddies, look at this mega piece of module that came out.
Don't bring more light in. Awesome.
It says fire hazard, caution. This is gonna go in the bin.
It's heavy. Wow, buddies, it's heavy.
Oh, our view has some proof lag with 25%. So up here, this is where the duct tape is for now. It was the hole, we put the cable behind it, but it's wet. The fabric is wet here, it's completely wet. So, gotta look into that. So at some point. Because if you look at papers, she does have a mirror.
No, they stick to it. Stuck
but
in
it doesn't fold up properly. So if I would remove only this, Peter wears always fancy sunglasses anyway. Then we will win an enormous amount of light.
Yes, we do.
For Petra.
Mm-hmm.
If you can deal with having no more mirror than this.
I've never looked in it ever.
So for now, I think we can screw off Petra's flap.
Wait for me.
So, since we're being in demolition mode,
yeah.
Next thing is this weird dashboard thing.
We don't use it.
We don't use it.
Maybe it does.
It was supposed to indicate, I mean, the previous owner never showed how it worked or explained it.
Nope.
He just said, well, yeah, it's there, it shows you if you're level or not, or it helps you level. We never use it. It was for
it just tells us we're in a straight line. You see? Okay. Oh, good. Ah.
See, ready?
What you doing?
We just get a spark, but he's cutting some wires.
Yes.
So that gave us like quite a scare.
Mm.
And of course, we're now thinking that everything can work. But everything's so old in this van. And I just removed the 12-volt plug holder as well. That explains the big hole in the dash. But it also was like connected with all kind of wiring half open, hanging open, and doesn't look very confident. And I'm just trying to get this box off. But it's attached under the dash and I cannot reach it. So we're gonna see if we can figure out a way to get in there. But it looked very easy, but it was not. I mean, there's a reason that people have an education for these things.
Yes.
But on the other hand, we want to make this our home. Look at this. Look at this monster. This was on a dashboard. Don't you fit in the bin? Bin bag. In the bucket.
Wow, light. Look with a view, please.
Yes.
Awesome.
Now we're going to start the van. There was a sparky wire. I cut it. And it fell down into the hole. We cannot find it anymore. So I'm going to start the van. And Peter is going to film the explosion.
Yes. So far, so good.
Do you see anything
sparking?
Maybe you can, you guys can find it. Oh yeah, and there's a bunch of wiring as well. So guys, so you do picking. At least the van still starts. That's something. Right?
It's relief. Let's go outside, buddies. Check if everything works. Yep. In the back. To work.
Thanks, Petra, for going out.
You're welcome.
I still got a half tank of fuel.
Oh, yeah.
If the tank is... We just look at life with the tank half full and not the tank half empty. So that's our optimistic view of van life. The tank is half full. You can't go wrong there. The weirdest thing, buddies, we're just testing the engine. As you know, it was very short. See if everything worked. Testing the windows up and down and the radiator. And this woman next to us, she comes up to the window. She says, are you guys leaving? You're starting the engine. I say, no. We're just testing if everything works. Well, it's very annoying and bothering us. I say, look, this is a mixed parking. It's not a paid camper spot. And she was like, yeah, but it's really annoying us. So I say, it's just a few minutes, not even a few minutes. And she's like, yeah, I'm very annoyed by it. I said, well, then you have to go. They got wheels. Who approaches people like that? She started to attack us right away out of the blue. Well, if you are nice to us, if you're nice, we're nice. Can you approach us? Yes, we're very approachable. We, a lot of times we have very nice chats with people on the camper spots and spend afternoons and evenings together. We think it's important to tell people about living the van life and
how we manage in a small van. People usually are curious. And that's why we made the merch also, to show how approachable we are, and van life is a great topic and everything. So we're very approachable. If you approach us nice, we're nice back. But if you don't approach us nice, we're also not nice back. So I was not very nice to this lady that showed up. And the biggest favor somebody can do you is showing up at your window, letting you know that they're crazy. Because then we know exactly what we want to do. We don't want to be near crazy. So it's very easy for us. We just remove ourselves from the craziness. And that's how we keep ourselves happy. That's how we keep van life happy and everything happy. Just remove yourself from the craziness. That's how you deal with crazy people. That's the secret. Because crazy people, they thrive on you being around for them to showcase their craziness and crazy behavior on. So the longer you stay, the more you do them a favor. Because you're not doing yourself any favors, because from that moment a crazy shows up, all you can do is think about that crazy person or persons next to you. And the longer you stay, the more you open yourself up, the more crazy. And the more you go into the defense or into attack versus crazy, the more they thrive. The more they thrive in getting you from your state of zen and happiness into like an angry, frustrated state. And that's winning for them. It's winning for them to take you off your mountain of sunshine and pull you into the valley of crazy. Because then, that's where they live. They live in those dark, muddy, musky, smelly shades, swampy areas. So, but one thing you have to understand, it's not a sign of weakness if we make a positive choice to remove ourselves from crazy. And then leave that crazy person the feeling that they won. That they won by you leaving. But in reality, they lost. They lost out. They missed out on meeting awesome people. They missed out on great conversation. They missed out on being inspired. If you weigh it and you say, well, what's to win by staying around here crazy? I cannot think of any reason why we should stay. If somebody really tells you up front, and your knocks on your window and says, hey, look, I'm crazy, I thank them very much, because then we know immediately what we have to do. We have to remove ourselves. And if we could go to war, that can end badly for the van, can end badly for us, getting end up being in a fight, getting arrested. It would be great content, of course, but there's nothing to gain. And if you then remove yourself from the equation, physically, I mean, we're on wheels. We're on wheels. What am I talking about? Why are we still standing there? We're on wheels. Happiness is around the corner. It's around every bend. Every turn that we take is new happiness. Happiness. You never guess what time it is. It's 21:30 in the evening. That's PM. And it's still light outside. How is that possible? Let's ask Petra, she knows those things.
It's the beginning of summer, the longest day. Yes.
It's the longest day, buddies. So they say always in the news, yeah, longest day, still light, very, very late. And we're like, let's test it. Yeah. Let's test that theory. I mean, what better time to drive at night as during the longest day of the year? And normally you would be in bed already, because you would have to work in the morning. You'd close the curtains so the neighbors don't look in and see the stuff you have. But we're just driving, we're experiencing it for the first time in 40 years. The longest day is actually, it's true. It's not an urban legend. Look, buddies. It's completely light. What's up with that, buddies?
It's completely light. It's completely light. Right, right. That means, are you representing the birds?
I'm cold.
You're cold? Yes. Petra's cold. She's not representing the birds. So, but we're going to a place that has a big sized clothing. So maybe we pick up some merch for me, so I can represent it too.
It's 10 o'clock and still light. How awesome is that?
Super awesome.
It's 10:30 and it's still sort of light out.
Dark probably in about 15 minutes. But how awesome! The longest day.
Mm, it truly is.
I think we have a title right there.
Mm-hmm.
This video.
It's almost 11 o'clock and still light.
No way.
Yes, way.
The sun doesn't go down anymore, but it's.
You never guess what happened.
What happened?
We got our first t-shirt order. Thank you very much. You know who you are?
Arden Timmer.
Yes, Arden Timmer. Thank you very much. Because you're the first to order, we will personally drive over and hand deliver it in person. Thank you very much.